Hello everyone, today I am explaining you numerical based on the chapter 11 time and motion. So the numericals, they are based on calculation of time period. First let us understand what is time period. This is your simple pendulum, this is the thread, this is the bob is your metal ball. Now, I've already explained in the previous video that this is the mean position when it is not moving. When the simple pendulum moves, it goes to extreme position, and again on the other side there is another extreme position. Okay. So the time required from A to B, B to again A, then from A to C and C to again A, when this bob will complete one complete oscillation, the time required to complete this one oscillation is termed as time period. It is A to B, then B to again A, यहाँ से यहाँ जाएगा, फिर यहाँ से वापस आएगा, फिर ए से फिर सी पे जाएगा, और फिर सी से फिर वापस ए पे आएगा. दिस कम्प्लीट वन ऑसिलेशन अगर हम मेन पोजिशन से स्टार्ट करें. सिमिलरली वी कैन स्टार्ट वन ऑसिलेशन फ्रॉम एनी एक्सट्रीम एंड. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ़ वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम बी, सो फ्रॉम बी जस्ट सेकेंड. Okay, so from B it will go to A, then it will go to C, from C it will come back to A, then it will again, from A it will come back to B. Okay, so this is again one complete oscillation, B to A, A to C, C to A, and finally to B. We can do it with the C also, another extreme. From C it will go to A, A to B, B to C, then from A to again C. Always make sure that the ends are same. It starts at A, it ends at A. It starts at B, it ends at B. It starts at C, it ends at C. Okay, so the time required to complete one oscillation is time period. Now the formula time taken upon number of oscillations. So here the question is, calculate the time period if the pendulum completes 45 oscillations in 90 seconds. Now you have this formula. So time period equal to time taken upon number of oscillations. So now here you have 90 seconds and the oscillations are 45. So you just divide this, you get the answer as 2 seconds. The time period is 2 seconds. Similarly, we have another question. इन दिस इट सेज सॉरी इट सेज देर इज़ अ बॉब, ठीक है, दिस इज योर सिंपल पेंडुलम. दिस बॉब टेक्स 1 सेकेंड टू गो फ्रॉम एक्सट्रीम पोजिशन टू मीन पोजिशन. ओके, सो दिस इज द एक्सट्रीम पोजिशन एंड दिस इज द मीन पोजिशन. ओके, सो दिस टाइम from this extreme end, to this mean end, it takes 1 second. Now they are asking you to calculate time period. Now we very well know that time period is 4 times of this. From this extreme, it goes to it goes to this position mean, then it goes to another extreme. It come back. This is one, this is 2, again it will come 3, then it will again go back 4, only then one oscillation will get complete. So if in this it takes 1 second, then 4 times of this will be complete one oscillation, and that and the time required for that one oscillation will be your time period. So you will say the time required for Bob to move from extreme end to mean end is equal to 1 second. For one complete oscillation, the bob has to cover this distance 4 times, right? So for one oscillation, time required is equal to 4 into 1 second, that is equal to 4 seconds. Also, I'd like to make one point that time is always same. If you go from this point to this point, or you go from this to this, like if I just write A over here, A, this is B, this is C, so the time for A to B, B to C is always same. So if it is taking 1 second from A to B, so it will always take 1 second from B to C, and similarly it will take 1 second from C to B and from B to A. I hope the question is clear to you. I have given similar question in assignment. Try to do them. If still you face any problem, just message on my personal window. I would be happy to help you.